Hi, I'm Karen Bystedt, and welcome to my show, The ArcLight. This is a photograph I took of Brad Pitt. He knew what he wanted, and it's amazing that he manifested his dream. And this is a shot of Robert Downey, who I hung out with at a reggae club. I think I met him, that's where I met him. And he was already doing quite well. But it was before, obviously, he won his Academy Award. So was my neighbor. And she was an aspiring actress when I met her. And I always thought she had these beautiful movie star looks. And I really wanted to photograph her in a glamorous way with red lipstick. And we shot these on my room on Oakwood Avenue, by the Grove, which didn't exist at that time. And Sandra really, really believed in herself, and I manifested her dream. And she wore this wig. This is actually a wig, which was very similar to what she ended up wearing as a hairstyle at Speed. And it's fascinating, because she used to ask about Keanu Reeves, who I photographed. And that was before they worked together. And of course, that was her big breakout role as a star. Yeah. Of course, I have a beautiful shot of the exhibition as well. I shot Patrick at a very famous fashion photographer studio, Patrick Demarchier. And this is before Ghost. So Patrick went on to be a huge star. And he's a beautiful, beautiful soul. I really enjoyed him. And after the shoot, Patrick and I went out and had coffee and hung out. I think it's a beautiful shot, and I hope I capture a little bit of the soul. These shots of Brad Pitt were taken on a rooftop in Hollywood on Franklin Avenue. And Brad told me stories of sitting in his sandbox, thinking about being the big guy of Hollywood. And at that time, he was struggling, doing his own laundry. And of course, now he is the big guy, so, and doing a lot of amazing things. With Angelina Jolie, that's an homage to Brad Pitt. I photographed Johnny Depp twice. I photographed him when he was on 21 Jump Street, and I remember when he lived on Whitley Avenue, and I was there with his dad, and he was just smoking some cigarettes, and we were hanging out in his little Hollywood apartment, and then he. And he told me that he really wanted to do something different and not be your typical Hollywood guy. And I ended up actually shooting this for an Edward Jeans campaign. And I rented that beautiful Buick with the flames. And as it turned out, Johnny owned the same car without the flames. So he's a very bright, amazing artist. I have a lot of respect for him. When I met him, his pants were torn, and his shirt was torn, and he lived in this the flats, and he was drinking wine, but he was just messy and beautiful and brilliant, and I had a lot of fun with Keanu. So again, this is just a very classic, beautiful picture of Sandra Bullock that I took on my roof. She's just wearing a white t-shirt, and I think I caught a little bit of her depth and her soul, reflecting on wanting to manifest her career, which she did. And this is one of my favorite.
I think she had a crush with Keanu too,
and she was actually my neighbor. We used to walk our dogs together, and she used to ask me what Keanu was like, because I had already photographed him, probably like 3 years before I photographed her. Sandra had a movie called Love Potion Number 9, which was going to come out, which she thought was going to make her a star, and did not. So it just goes to show perseverance. It's very important. You've got to be able to pick yourself up from disappointment and keep going. And this show is called They Dare to Dream, and these people dare to dream. So I would like to put it out to you.
So Jaime Ponsu
had not been an Amistad yet. I must be a catalyst to really help people, because he was a model and had just been in a Janet Jackson video. He did tell me in our interview together that he really wanted to get into acting. And a year later, he was cast in Amistad, and I think this is a beautiful shot. I took this in Topanga on the beach at sunset, and I was living in a small studio apartment, and Brad was a struggling actor who was working but was living in a very small apartment, which he shared with two guys, and he talked about reading Sam Shepard and having dreams of wanting to make it and drive up Oscar night and be the number one guy, which he's now achieved. So it's pretty remarkable and inspiring, and I hope you enjoy my show. It correlates with my book, They Dare to Dream. My book, They Dare to Dream, is actually on sale on my website, theydaretodream.com, and also here at the ArcLight bookstore. And it includes my interviews with all these amazing, inspirational actors. And I think that for me, the show is about daring to dream. And it's so inspiring that these people that I chose and interviewed and photographed dared to dream and were able to push through their fears and manifest their success, which is such a difficult thing to do. And it's inspirational for me, as I hope it is for you. Thank you. I think you can dream as big as it can possibly be. And I just think you have to, you know, really get through the fear, get through the rejection, pick yourself up again. And the reason I chose that title is that when I met these people, they were dreaming. They were dreaming big, and they were able to push through their fears and manifest those dreams. So I think that's very inspirational for us all. Most of them did have agents and managers. Brad, at the time, did have a side pocket. He had an agent, a very big agent, but it was the agent's assistant who was actually sending him out and believed in him and who actually sent him to me. So I don't think he was fully signed, but he was working. He was doing some television, some independent
seeking out
talented artist actors who I thought would have long, thriving careers, and who I felt were in it for the right reasons, and who were also very diverse and different from each other. I didn't want to just choose pretty people, and I didn't want to just, you know, I wanted to show people who were different individuals, but who I felt would have interesting careers. I mean, to be honest, I didn't really know that they would become today's biggest stars, so I guess I was coming from a true place as an artist myself.